H2K Infosys provides world-class online IT training, staffing and software testing solutions to customers worldwide. H2K Infosys supports 100% job-oriented training, hands-on project work, cloud test lab, resume preparation and review, mock interviews, robust syllabus. One-time pay, lifetime access to live classes and videos. H2K Infosys has won the trust of thousands of students worldwide. For free demo class, visit h2kinfosys.com.
So as I told earlier, we are going to start loops here. What is loops? So understand this is not only a Python, but every programming language faces this issue. Whenever we need to solve a problem number of times, imagine I have to actually let's say we have a university problem here. I have 600 students and for all of them we have to calculate percentile, correct? So what you have to do, you have to take the marks, add them up, correct, and then calculate the percentile, correct? But the activity which I am explaining here has to repeat for 600 student, right? So for student number one, this thing happens. Student number two, this thing happens. It continues to happen for 600 student. No change in the logic, only change in the data, correct? Whenever we have certain scenario like that, what we do is we loop through it. That means we take the entire set of data, okay, and then loop through it one by one. What is a loop? Is iteration from value 1 to value n. Okay, so value n being the initial value or starting value and n being the end value, and you're gonna iterate, you're gonna check, you're gonna use the same exact logic for every single iteration. Good with that? Now there are two kinds of loop exist. The first one is when you exactly know this n. That means the example I just discussed, 600 students. I know there are 600 students. I know I have to start from roll number 1 to roll number 600. But there are scenarios where you cannot say that. Okay, when? So suppose I am actually reading a data from file. Okay, so this file has a data and I am reading line by line. So first line, second line, third line, fourth line, and goes on. So now I do not have a clue which line is the last line, whether it's 600th line or 100th line, correct? So this kind of scenario, we are dependent on a condition, whether file end is arrived. So now there are two types of loop. One where you exactly know where to stop or what is the end point. One where you are dependent on a condition. So whenever a condition becomes false, you will stop looping. Here, whenever you cross that particular end mark, you achieve that end mark and you are done. Here, I read line number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 up to 100 and I ask for 101st line, but that 101st line doesn't exist. That's why I am stopping that loop. Okay? So there are two types of loop, one which are dependent on conditions and they will continue till the condition is true. Another is you start from one value, end with n value. What with this? Okay, so let's try to understand loops in Python and which are the loops and which category. What with that? So let's start. Okay, so starting first is a while loop. While loop is a second kind of loop. That means we are dependent on a condition. So while loop is used whenever you do not have an idea how many times you want to iterate. Good with that? So we will use while loop for that purpose only. But is it right? You cannot use it for other purpose? Yes, you can. Whenever you know the end point, still also you can use while loop. But then you kind of defeat the purpose because there is somebody else who is doing that task efficiently. Now for the example, because we don't know file reading yet, we don't know database values reading yet, That's why, for the example, we are taking a simpler one where we know the endpoint, but ultimately we are writing a condition. Okay, so we are dependent on a condition. So how does while loop really look like? So while loop looks like this. It says while, and after that you have a condition. Okay, and then you have a block of code. When condition is true. Okay, so this is the while loop structure. Now let's go ahead and create a first while loop test in our PyCharm so that you understand it. Good with that? Any questions up to this point? We have to take an example. After example, let's get clarified more. So it's learn underscore day 03. And I'm actually writing a while loop. So creating a Python file, and I'll say test while loop. Okay, I'm gonna take a variable first, and I'll define it as count or counter equals 0. What with that? And now I want to do what? So first I have to write my problem statement. My problem statement is adding numbers from 1 to 10. Let's see what the sum is. Okay. So now here I have a condition. The condition is my counter value cannot be more than 10. That's my condition. So I'm dependent on that. So I'll say while counter is less than or equals 10. Okay. Less than or equals 10. You can write that condition in brackets, no issues with that. And here you are starting your block of code. So the block of code will execute only when the condition is true. Okay, so block, that means that condition is true, and value of counter is counter. Got it? So the value of counter is counter. What happened exactly? We are just checking whether condition is true or not, right? So now I'll have one more variable which will add it. So I'll just say total equals 0, and then you can use total equals total plus counter. Now this is achievable in every programming language. Okay, that means a new value of total equals old value of total plus counter. So this is possible in any programming. This is not seen in mathematics, but this is always seen like in programming languages where you use such kind of expressions where new value of total equals old value of total plus counter. Good with this? Okay. So now if I write this particular loop this way, what's going to happen? It will actually come here. It will check if counter is less than 10. That condition satisfies because counter is 0. That is true. So this statement will get executed, and total will also get upgraded. Okay. Although there is no upgrade because total is 0 and counter is also 0. And what will happen? This is end of the loop. Okay. I'm not having any statement here. It will come back and check the condition again, and check if that condition is still positive. Condition is positive still, counter is still 0, and it's gonna continue with the same manner, and it will continue forever. It will not change anything, and this kind of loop is called as endless loop. Do not do that. Just make sure that your condition should be false at certain scenario. If that doesn't happen, basically you are writing an endless loop. Good with that? So to avoid endless loop, we have to increase this counter. So now you can increase the counter. You can use counter plus plus. Okay. Or you can just say counter equals counter plus 1. So you are increasing the counter by 1. So what now happens? Now let's understand the loop again. Counter value is 0. Now here in print statement it's printing this. Total equals to total plus counter. Let's start off counter from 1, let's say, because there is no meaning of it in the first loop. So total is 0. So total equals to 0 plus 1. Then counter is increased by 1. Now counter value is what? 2. Come back here. Is 2 less than 10? Yes. Print it. Add it. 3. Less than 10? Yes. Print it. Add it. 4. Less than 10? Yes. 5. Yes. 6. Yes. 7. Yes. 9. Yes. On 10. Yes. Correct. On 10, it says, okay, it's not less, but it equals to. So still enters into the block of code. And now what happens? Counter equals to counter plus 1, it converts into 11. Now 11 is not less than 10. So that means block of code. Now this one condition is false. Now condition is false, it will jump out of the loop. So you can just see print. This is out of loop. And then you can print the both values. Okay. So we just say counter, add that value here. And I told you how to do that with F statement also. So if you are comfortable with that, go ahead and use F also. So F value of counter, and then value of, you can just say counter, and total is, and then you can just say again total. Good with this? We actually learned this. What is F statement? Okay, basically you can replace these values from the. Okay, so now are you ready to run this loop? Do you have any question understanding this? Any question? Okay, so now we are going to execute this block of code and see what happens. Good with this? So right click and run test while loop. Okay, condition is true and this is how it works. Condition is true and counter is 1. Okay, then counter is 2, 3, 4 up to 10. And finally, out of the loop, what happened? Counter value was 11 and total was 55. Good with this? That's while loop. While loop always dependent on this. So when exactly while loops are used? So you have to always remember, while loops are used, first example is for reading files, because we don't know how, where is the end of file, correct? Then the second example will be for DB operations, because if I am having a SQL query, let's say select star from store. How many stores I'm gonna get? I don't have idea unless I specify that in my query. If I use select star, I do not have an idea how many rows are gonna come for that particular operation. So whenever you have certain scenarios when you do not have an idea how many times you're gonna iterate and you are dependent on a condition, you use while loop. Okay, so I'll just write that thing. It's like while loop are used when loop is dependent on condition. Correct? Loop is dependent on condition, and if condition is false, you are coming out of the loop. Got it? Clear? Any questions up to this point? So there are two awesome things called as break and continue. So we're gonna learn that. So now with break statement, you can stop the loop even if while condition is true. So what is break? Break is you wanna stop the loop in between. Now in this example, there is no logic of having break, but let's say I'm going back to the file reading example. You are reading a file and you are reading the file line by line, okay? So let me show you an example file here, a real data file, which is used for one of the projects. There you go. So this is one of the file which is called, which is actually used for one of the project called CDAP. And you have to do that project when we are done with a file reading operation. So in this particular file, the data is coming like this. Okay. So you are reading the data line by line. So you read this line. This is the data for David Nix. You read this line. This is the data for Neil Armstrong. And you have Donita's data, Logan's data, Kurt's data, and all those things. So now you are reading the data line by line. Now suppose I got something weird here. Okay. A data which is not good enough. Data which is not able to understand. Okay. In this scenario, suppose this data. Now this particular file, let's say if there is any bad data, you don't have a clue what this data is, so that's fine. We can just imagine any data is a bad data. Let's say 7th is a bad data, and my project leader or my requirements of the project is, as soon as I see a bad data, I have to stop reading file. How do I do that? So if I'm reading line number 1, line number 2, line number 3, up to 7th line, everything is smooth. But on 7th line, I found that the bad data arrived. And I don't want to insert bad data anywhere. Good with that. And my project spec says, or my project leader says, that as soon as I see bad data, I have to come out of the code. How do I do that? Because my while loop is written like that. I'm reading entire file now. The condition is still true. You can do that with the help of break statement. So break will help you to stop the loop, okay, anywhere. So break will help to stop the loop any point. Of course, you have to write a condition for that. So now I'm going to write a condition here in this loop itself. Now we are going to use the same loop with the same counters. I'm not touching this example. Now, what we are going to do is, we are inserting break statement. Now, what happens is, I want the condition to break, or the loop to break, when value arrives at 6. When counter value is 6, I want to break that statement. How do I do that? So now you are anyway printing the counter value, you are anyway adding the total. What I will do is, I will add statement here, like if counter is 6. Okay, you may or may not add parenthesis, that is up to you. And then here I'm going to write break. So as soon as I write break, what happens? Whenever this particular condition gets satisfied, break will execute, and as soon as break arrives, what will happen? You will see that the counter is no longer updated, the conditions are no longer executed, and you are jumping out of the loop. Okay, so now here I'm just saying testing break statement. Okay, and value of counter is this one. Good with this. Out of loop, counter is this and total is this. So what's gonna happen? Counter will be 6, and that's where you're gonna come out. So this value should be 6, and you will see the total up to 6 only. Run this test. So you can see that testing break statement value is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. After that break statement get executed, you are jumping out of the loop at value 6 and total is 21. When exactly we are doing that? When we have certain scenario where you do not want to continue the loop. And I gave you a practical example where in file reading operation, in database reading operation, you got the bad data. You got the bad row of the file. At that time, bad line in the file. At that time, you can break that loop and discontinue the execution of the loop. Okay? So this is discontinuation. Good with that? Questions up to this point? On the other hand, if what I have to do, or what my project leader says, that if there is a bad data, instead of terminating the file, let's skip this file itself and continue to the next value. So I have some validations. My validation fails on this particular line and continue to the next line. This is what I have to do. This is not break then. This is different. This thing is called as continue statement. So continue allow you to skip a loop counter. Continue will allow to skip a loop counter. A loop iteration, I'll say. Okay, so that logic of the loop will not get executed. You'll directly jump to the next value of the loop. Good with that? So that we're gonna do now. So again, I'm actually doing the same value, same loop. And now testing continue statement. So my statement is, I want to continue. I don't want to add 6. Now my loop will not come here. I don't want to add 6. Now as soon as I see that, as soon as I have that condition, so you're testing that, and now I'm actually checking if my counter is 6. What I have to do? Continue. But if I do that, value are still 6, so you have to increase your counter first. So just add a counter. Good with this. So what happened here? Counter equals to 6, then change the counter, make it 7, and then continue. Continue means what? It will not execute this block of code. Okay, so you will not be okay. Rather, don't do it here. Do it here itself. So you'll not even print that value. So counter equals to 6, it will actually check, it will increase that counter and continue. Good with that? Otherwise, it will continue to execute the normal value. So value is 1, okay, you are fine, nothing happens here. Okay, added, okay, then go to the next value up to 5. When the value is 6, counter equals to 6, yes, counter equals to 7 now, and continue. So as soon as it says continue, these three statements will be skipped and it will jump to the next value of the loop. And next iteration of the loop, now counter is 7 and you can actually see this. Okay, so this is opposite of break statement. It's continue statement. So run this now. Continue statement 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now after that 6 is skipped. Okay, and you can just say 7, 8, 9, 10. Okay, counter value is 11 and total is 49. But with that, so you saw break. So there is a difference between break and continue. What's that? Break actually terminates the loop as soon as it executes break. Continue though skips that particular iteration, but continue with the loop. Okay. Questions up to this point? How to stop the program if you make a mistake? You can terminate that program. Okay, there is a button here which should terminate. Okay, just like here. This is a red button. It will activate stop. Okay, so you can see stop. Just click on it to stop. Without even exiting, yes, you can do that. And if you do that on your command prompt, just put Control C, it will stop the execution. Okay. Where did 55 came from? 55 is total. It is totaling of all these numbers. Okay. When I try to do the code, it says my F is undefined. Just make sure that there is no gap between your F and your print statement. Okay, so that actually differs. This F and this print should not have a gap. Otherwise, you'll get an error. Okay, it should be attached to each other. We cannot run partial code. Okay. Every time I have to select the script path. Why? Which script path? I did not understand the question.